International presents the Very Merry Christmas Tour, featuring new songs, Audio Adrenaline, girls will be queens, Sidewalk Prophets, Jason Castro, and special guest Lovin' the Outcome. Share the gift of hope with your family and friends this season and enjoy one of Christian music's most beloved Christmas songs. Join New Song for the Very Merry Christmas Tour, featuring New Song, Audio Adrenaline, Sidewalk Prophets, Jason Castro, and Lovin' the Outcome.
Presented by Fairfield Christian Academy at Fairfield Christian Church in Lancaster, December 11th at 7 p.m., doors open at 6. Tickets at itickets.com. LancasterOhio.tv presents the Mid-State League Game of the Week, where Fairfield County High School athletes show their drive to succeed and their commitment to teamwork. This broadcast is a community service of Fairfield Media, high school media students and volunteers working hard to bring you the best in Mid-State League sports. Turn it on, crank it up. It's time for the MSL on LSM.
From Jack Johnson Field in Canal, Winchester, Ohio. Hi again, everybody. Jack Davidson along with Jordan Mills and the FCA media team. Tonight, it's a Mid-State Cardinal League matchup. It's the Fairfield Christian Academy Knights at 3-0 in the conference against the Harvest Prep Warriors at 2-1. Dane Alexander is our sideline reporter tonight. Dane, what do you have for us?
Tonight, we're here to watch the FCA Knights versus the Warriors. And tonight it's going to be a very good match, I believe, and it's going to be very cold. Right now it's about 40 degrees out, and it's only going to drop. It's going to probably be a low of 33 before the end of the game. So we need to make sure that the players stay warm by keeping their layers on the sidelines, being hydrated, and also stretch every so often. Back to you, Jack.
You're looking good, Dane. You need some hot chocolate out there, I tell you. Nice hat, too. Jordan Mills is with us, our color commentator tonight. Jordan, welcome to the broadcast.
Well, thank you for having me. Excited to be a part of the broadcast tonight and look forward to tonight's game.
Tonight's Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Brought to you in part by Service Master Clean by Todd George. Cleaning services for Fairfield County that help you get clean and stay that way at work and at home. Service Master Clean by Todd George is proud to be a Six Sigma company, demonstrating their commitment to excellence and their promise to do the job right or do it over. Service Master Clean by Todd George, 740-687-1077. Harvest Prep will receive. It'll be going right to left on the TV screen. Junior Collins is the kicker. He's going to tee it up at the 40-yard line. Jordan, what should we expect from Harvest Prep tonight?
Well, you're going to want to look at their defense. Defense is their strength. They've struggled passing the ball. Offensively, they're going to run it a lot. So we'll definitely look for the defense to make some key stops here against the Knights.
12 minutes on the clock. Official Lee Hubbard blows the whistle, and Collins puts the boot into the ball. We're underway. Ball goes out of bounds. And Harvest Prep will start in good field position. Tonight's officials, Lee Hubbard, Tony Gray, Jeremy Haffill, Rayford Wheatley, and Morgan Stevens. FCA coached by B.J. Queen in his first year. Last week, FCA beat Millersport by a score of 62-14.
And Harvest Prep is also, they're coming off a win against Burn Union last week, 28-13. So both teams coming off wins here.
Quarterback is R.J. Johnson. That play went nowhere. The ball carrier Gideon Woodson-Levy might have gained one on the play. It'll be second and 9. Johnson over center. pitch. That was Whitson Levy again. And that'll go for maybe a half a yard. It'll be third and long.
Harvest Prep has some fast guys on the team, so if they can just break through the Knights defensive line there, they can definitely take off, but they got to do that first.
Third and eight. Johnson rolling out right, looking. Going to keep it, and he's hit and dropped. He'll bring up fourth down as Harvest Prep will punt the ball away. FCA comes in tonight, record of 5-3. Harvest Prep overall record 3-5. Jack Johnson, their coach, in his ninth season. Of course, he's a Hall of Fame coach. Coached at Pickerington Central. Good snap. High short kick. It's going to hit about the 47. Take a sideways bounce, and it's going to go out of bounds right in front of a broadcast position at the 46-yard line for FCA. Good field position for the Knights. Yard Butler Lawn and Landscape Service is proud to serve Central Ohio communities with a full array of services designed to enhance any landscape. The Yard Butler is scheduling fall cleanups with affordable packages at 740-808-2580 or online at ohioyardbutler.com. You're a student at OU, right?
That is correct.
So you don't have to worry about lawns, do you?
I don't. I live in a nice apartment down there. Don't have to worry about any of that stuff.
Jeremiah Lee, a quarterback for the Knights. And we have an infraction. Let's see if it's on FCA for movement or offside on Harvest Prep. It's going to be on Harvest Prep, backing them up five. First and five for the Knights. Jeremiah Lee is at quarterback. 6'1", 175-pound junior. Running backs Caleb Walds, Lane Toman, and, of course, the big man, Ben Tobin.
Harvest Prep can put up some big defensive stops. They're known for their defense. Let's see what they can do here.
We have around left end. It's Jacob Walker. It'll be second and short. Play worked a lot last week against Millersport. Looks like be second and two. Of course, FCA is known for their running offense. This being the ninth game of the season, you figure Harvest Prep is well-versed in that, huh?
Yeah, they are.
That play will go nowhere.
Looks like there's no gain on the play.
There's
there.
Ben Tobin. Harvest Prep defense snuffed that one out. Now bring up third and short.
A lot of guys you want to look out for on the Harvest Prep defensive line is going to be King is a key guy, as well as Whitson Levy. And then number 54 for Prep, and that is Hunter Ferris.
A lot of speed for the Warriors. See how the Knights cope. There's Walker. Fumbles out of bounds. It'll be a first down for the Knights. Jacob got the corner and cut up nicely for a first down. Other games in the area tonight. Lancaster takes on Grove City, which is interesting looking at Twitter. Lancaster had trouble getting to Grove City. If you ever been to Grove City, it's just a traffic jam.
Oh,
it's a parking lot.
I
at
work.
71.
And yeah, so I worked in Hilliard for a while, and driving from Pickerington to Hilliard, you got to go through Grove City. It's no fun.
Ben Tobin up the gut. Close to the goal line. First down for the Knights. Ben Tobin. Good quick hitter by the Knights. Anyway, Lancaster 5-3 is at Grove City tonight. 4-4. Grove City won last year by a score of 31-12. 12. First and goal for the Knights. And it'll be second goal for the Knights. Circleville goes to Liberty Union. That'll be a good game. Circleville's at 6-2. Liberty Union at 7-1. Hamilton Township at 5-3. Travels to Bloom Carroll also at 5-3. Fisher Catholic at 3-5. Travels to Burn Union tonight. They're 1-7. Tays Valley's at Fairfield Union. Grove City Christian's at Millersport. Logan Elms at Amanda Clear Creek. Second and goal. It's Walker around the left end. Touchdown for the Knights. Jacob Walker with a 1-yard touchdown run around left end. They'll make it 6-0 for the Knights with the point after to follow. It comes at the 7:58 mark of the first quarter of play. Junior Collins on for the point after. Walker will hold. Ball down, kick is up, and the kick is good. Timeout on the field, 7:58 to go. First quarter of play. Knights lead Harvest Prep early in this one by a score of 7-0. Fairfield Christian Academy presents the Very Merry Christmas Tour with New Song, Audio Adrenaline, Sidewalk Prophets, Jason Castro, and Loving the Outcome on Wednesday, December 11th at 7 at Fairfield Christian Church in Lancaster, Ohio. More details at itickets.com. And you can help a child smile this Christmas by packing a shoebox with school or hygiene items and small toys, and you deliver that packed box to FCA by November 15th. Packing ideas, labels, and more details are available at the website SamaritansPurse.org. Knights kept it on the ground that time, and that drive was helped by an offside penalty on Harvest Prep. Knights started at their own 46 and capitalized on the Jacob Walker touchdown. Collins, short kick, fielded at the 31 to the 37-yard line. Ross Hunter was the receiver on that. So it'll be first and 10 now for Harvest Prep. Ball at the 35. Now Woodson Levy will split out on a slot right side. Johnson rolls, throws, overthrows his intended receiver.
It's one thing Harvest Prep has been struggling at this whole year is passing and making a connection downfield.
Intended receiver there was Judah Tutt.
You'll see that Prep typically will stay with their running game.
Second and 10, 7:47 to go here. First quarter play. Still going.
Looks like we got a first down for Prep.
And that's a good run there by Woodson Levy. So Harvest Prep, that should be first down yard, unless, looks like they have a penalty flag on the play. They're going to back up Harvest Prep.
Say possibly holding.
That's what it looks like. Backs them up to the 25-yard line. So it'll be second about 20.
Didn't see a call on the field from the ref.
They don't care about us.
They don't.
You're in broadcasting. That's one of the first rules you'll learn, right? Johnson rolling, fires long, overthrows his intended receiver out there on the left side.
Looks like the receiver there for prep kind of just slowed down a little bit.
That was Carlisle Wilson.
Yep.
Bring up third and long. He was open.
He was open, but for some reason he just didn't run that one all the way out.
You know, it is tough to throw the ball when you're on the run.
Yeah.
And, you know, game time temperature night's about 42 degrees. It doesn't help when it's cold. Third and long. Johnson rolling left. Looking, throws short. Got a receiver, but it'll be short of a first down. That was Robert King on the catch. And that'll bring up a punting situation for Harvest Prep. Collins and Tobin will be back for the Knights. Collins is the closest one to you. Good snap. High kick.
Pretty decent pump by Prep.
And it's going to take an FCA bounce and be downed at the 41. First and 10 for the Knights now, their second possession of the evening. And they lead 7-0.
Want to give a little shout out to the Harvest Prep Marching Band. This is their very first ever game. They're making their debut tonight. So pretty exciting atmosphere here at Jack Johnson Field.
And it is senior night too, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. All the seniors were honored before the game.
Let's see, how many seniors does Harvest Prep have? They got 2, 4, 6, about 9, right?
Yeah, 9 or 10. 9 seniors on the team. So definitely a pretty solid amount here.
First and 10 for the Knights. Lee over center.
Same play. Here you come. Coming this way.
Tobin gets the carry, and he'll hit the 40 to about the 41-yard line. Short gain will bring up second. We'll call it 2nd and 8. And I'll mark it at the 41. Coming up on the 6-minute mark here in the first quarter of play. Jack Davis along with Jordan Mills with you here on the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Walker. He'll be close to a first down. Depends where they spot it. Yes, get to the 49. They may mark it a yard short. It'll be 3rd and short. A 3rd and a long yard. Play has worked well for the Knights over the past few weeks. Two wide receivers to the left for the Knights. Walker. Now Tobin hits the 50-yard line. We'll get a first down. The market at 49 of Harvest Prep. First down for the Knights. Of course, Ben Tobin led all of Central Ohio and all of the state of Ohio in rushing last year.
Wow.
Went to a wing back this year. Now he's playing a halfback tonight.
He's definitely a playmaker out there for the Knights.
Walker in motion. Tobin will carry some tacklers for maybe a yard. Tobin, Walker. Fisher Catholic leads Burn Union by a score of 7-6 as Faulkner hits Stoughton for an 82-yard touchdown pass. Of course, the rivalry game next week will be there for you at Fulton Field. It'll be Fisher and FCA. Tobin hitting the backfield and drop. James Johnson on the tackle. I'll bring up third and 11. First passing situation for the Knights tonight.
Come on, Daquan.
Austin Beigel, wide right. He's at the bottom of the screen. Walker in motion. He'll set at the left side. Gives to Walker. Hit in the backfield and drop.
Nice play by Prep there.
So they'll bring up a punting situation. Lane Toman will come on to punt.
That was sophomore Tayshawn Colvin that brought down.
There's a line drive kick.
Go, 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 go!
I think that was Johnson on the reception, and he gets it to the 41-yard line. So, first and 10 now for Harvest Prep.
Come on. First and 10, Warriors.
They'll mark it at the 41-yard line. Pass to the right side. Snuffed out by the linebackers for FCA. That was R.J. Johnson on the catch. The quarterback there was Michael Lang.
Johnson trying to make some plays happen for Prep, but just can't get past that D-line of the Knights.
Second and 9. Ball at the 42. Two wide receivers to the left, one to the right for the Warriors. Low snap. Lang gets it, throws over the middle. It is caught.
It's a great catch right there by Prep.
There's Robert King on the receiving end. And the Warriors move the chains. First and 10 for Harvest Prep. They're going to mark it at the Knights' 42-yard line.
King is a senior at Harvest Prep, so a nice little catch for him here on senior night.
Lang over center. Rolling right. Throw right side. Missed his target there on
that'll
the right.
Judah Tutt.
Judah Tutt,
target.
The intended receiver. Second down and 10 with all a little bit over a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter. Harvest Prep fans are starting to get into it now as they start to stomp the bleachers.
Hear a couple cowbells out there too.
Lang directing his running backs now. Now they're going to be set. Lang. It's R.J. Johnson. He goes out of bounds. Going to bring up third and it looks like maybe 5. Well, let's say 3rd and 4.
36. Third down.
I'll mark it at the 36-yard line. Lang rolling right, throws, intercepted. FCA comes up with the turnover.
It's like Brian Miller with the pick from FCA.
See, that was Austin Green, I think.
I saw 33 come
was
up with
it. Was it 33?
Yep.
I saw 22, 33, who knows?
Either way, FCA's
got the ball. Yep. I thought it might have been Caleb Waltz, too, but our monitor is
I'd give it
small
about
here.
2.5-inch monitor there.
Yeah, but they're looking good.
Hey.
So FCA gets the turnover. First and 10, with 1:27 to go. And FCA will lose one on the play. And it'll bring up second down. Cold night here in Canal Winchester.
It certainly is. I'm pretty sure it's just as cold outside as it is inside this press box.
Yeah, at least we get the wind to break, don't we?
We do. Looks like they gained about 6 yards on that play.
Asante Palmer on the tackle for Harvest Prep. See, that was Lane Tolman on the carry. Ben Tobin hits the line of scrimmage and goes nowhere, and they'll bring up fourth down. So Tolman will come on to punt again. And as the clock winds down, we got one quarter in the books. Timeout on the field. The end of the first quarter of play, the Knights lead the Warriors 7-0 on the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN.
MSL on LSN, brought to you in part by
Service Master Clean by Todd George. They are proud to be the only Green Seal certified janitorial service in Central Ohio and promise to do the job right or do it over. 740-687-1077.
Central Ohio General Surgeons are physicians who have advanced training that allows them to perform invasive procedures for their patients. At Central Ohio General Surgeons, your appointment includes time for examination and discussion. Please feel free to ask any questions at any time. 740-654-6213. Thank them for supporting FMP Sports.
This week with Sheriff Dave Phelan on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Cable Channel 9. Great guests and important information on This Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan. Available online at LancasterOhio.tv.
A FCA turnover, a bad snap, and things went wrong there. So the Warriors take over in great field position.
Warrior football, first down.
Punt might have been blocked. So start the second quarter, Warriors with great field position. Along with Jordan Mills, Jack Davidson here. The FCA at Harvest Prep LSN Game of the Week. First and 10 for the Warriors. And the Knights snuffed that play out.
Yep, Johnson didn't go very far for Prep. Matter of fact, he went backwards.
So they'll bring up second and long. Hamilton Township leads Bloom Carroll 10-0. First half of play. Liberty Union leads 7-0 with 2:09 to go in the first. Lang at quarterback. Whitson Levy to his right. Low snap. Throws. It is intercepted again.
Is that Austin Green on the interception for the Knights?
And it looks to be like Austin Green.
Not sure where he was throwing.
That was Austin Green.
Yep.
course. Austin's got great hands. He's played second base, third base for the Knights baseball team. Second turnover, second interception of the Knights of the night for the Knights. And they'll take over. First and 10 now on their own 29.
Yeah, I mentioned it earlier. Harvest Prep struggles throwing the ball.
Ben Tobin up the gut for a couple. Bring up second and a long seven.
Student section here at Prep trying to make something happen for this football team on the field.
And off up the middle. First down for the Knights. Ben Tobin crossed the 40-yard line to about the 41. The Knights have run the ball exclusively tonight.
Tobin's done a great job tonight.
Yeah, Harvest Prep, on the other hand, they've mixed up the run and the pass with some success, but they have thrown two interceptions. Walker across the 45 to about the 47. Good gain. It'll bring up second down, and we'll call it second and a long four, maybe five. Veteran offensive line for the Knights doing a good job thus far, led by Josh Coleman, Austin Mosley. Tobin got a lane to the 40. 35 inside the 35 to about the 33, 32-yard line. First down, Knights.
Tobin was brought down by Tayshawn Colvin there at Prep.
Two evenly matched teams here tonight. Walker in motion. There's Caleb Walds.
He definitely powered through to get a couple yards there.
Caleb's my broadcast partner on the basketball side, so I imagine I'll be hearing about that this basketball season. He's a good baseball player too. Fine young man. All these guys are fine young men. It's a great thing. You got two great Christian schools like this.
Absolutely.
You got some quality people on both sides.
You do. That is for sure.
So it looks to be second and a long four, maybe 5 yards to go for the Knights. With about 8:40 to go here in the first half of play. Nice lead, 7-0. Caleb Waltz will be the deep back, and Tobin in motion. Walds will hit the 25-yard line, maybe get to the 24. And they'll bring up third and 3.
Up the middle.
Lee over center.
It's going to be close.
See if Tobin got it or not.
He did.
He did. They're
going
to move the chains. So, General Ben Tobin having a good first half here for the Knights. Talked about the even matchup here. FCA beat Grove City Christian by a score of 21-17. Harvest Prep beat Grove City by Christian by a score of 28-0. But that FCA score was not indicative of how FCA dominated. He just kept turning the ball over. Well, Central Ohio General Surgeons are physicians who have advanced training that allows them to perform invasive procedures for their patients. At Central Ohio General Surgeons, your appointment includes time for examination discussion, so please feel free to ask questions at any time. Central Ohio General Surgeons can be contacted at 740-654-6213. We thank them for supporting FCA Sports. And Redeemer Lutheran Church and yours truly have served the Lancaster area for over 50 years. Located at 1400 Concordia Drive in Lancaster, Sunday service at 10:15. Family Fall Festival is tomorrow, and that is at Redeemer Lutheran Church. See them online at redeemerlancaster.org. So first and 10 for the Knights. I'm going to thank Jordan Mills for joining us up here.
Absolutely. It's fourth been fun year, so far.
Fourth year broadcasting student at OU.
Yep.
Got a big game this week against Miami, don't they?
Yeah, they do. Big rivals. Battle of the Bricks. Now they play tomorrow, and it's also a Halloween weekend down there at OU.
It's good to be up here during Halloween weekend, isn't it?
It can get dangerous, that's for sure. I think some 20,000 people from out of town come out there.
Good gain there by Ben Tobin. And they'll bring up second and short. Into the first quarter, Liberty Union leads Circleville by a score of 7-0. Grove City is over leads Lancaster by a score of 7-0. And let's see. He's still moving.
Still moving. He may have got that first down. It's pretty close.
Tell you.
Is that Tobin on the run?
Ben is one tough hombre to bring down.
He is. They had about three or four Harvest Prep guys trying to bring him down.
And that will
first down.
Be a first down for the Knights inside the 10, so it should be first and goal. Or are they going to move the chains? They are. Let's see. So he must be right outside the 10. It looks like if he gets inside the 1, it'll be a first down. Walker off the right side. Touchdown, Knights. Jacob Walker, his second touchdown of the night. We'll call it a 10-yard run. At the 7:06 mark of the second quarter. Knights lead by a score of 13-0 with the point after to follow. Walker will hold, and Junior Collins on to attempt the extra point. Walker with 7 carries, 2 touchdowns. Ben Tobin has been carrying the mail for the Knights tonight. There's the ball down, kick is up, and it is good. Timeout on the field with a little over 7 minutes to go, first half of play. Knights lead by a score of 14-0 here at Harvest Prep on the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. This Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN airs Sundays at 4 on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. Games also available on demand at LancasterOhio.tv, powered by YouTube. So, Jason, you can go back and listen to your own golden tones. Fairfield Christian Church serves Lancaster for the past 40 years at the corner of Columbus and Whittier Streets near the River Valley Mall. Sunday morning services at 9 and 10:30. Trevor Littleton is currently exploring Deep Blue Faith. Visit them online at fairfieldchristian.org. And this week with Sheriff Dave Phelan on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9 has great guests and important information on This Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan, Mondays at 11 a.m. and 4 p.m., Tuesdays at noon and 9 p.m., only on LSN Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. Oh, and there's my church. You guys are so kind. Free spot.
Like we got Woodson, Levy, and Johnson in the backfield for Prep.
They love me down there, the switchers. And they're not members of my church, too, so that's...
Well, what's that about? You gotta get them on board there.
I may have to give them $10 at the end of the program. Here we go.
If you give me $10, I'll go to your church.
There you go. Short kick. And that ball goes backwards and out of bounds. And that will give Harvest Prep the ball. That was a live football throw went out of bounds. If the Knights would have recovered it, they would have been in great shape.
Yeah.
Looks like the Knights are afraid of the Warriors' receivers, or at least cautious, because the last two kicks have been short.
Yeah, they're fast. If they get the ball, they can definitely jet down the field.
So I guess the theory is, the procedure on the Knights are going to mark it at the 46 of Harvest Prep. Maybe 47-yard line. Theory is rather give them the ball at the 47, have them earn it, rather than have them run to the house, huh?
Yeah. Can't argue with that if you're the Knights.
First and 10 for Harvest Prep at their own 47-yard line. 7:04 to go, first half of play. That play will lose a couple yards.
It's like Caleb Waltz on the tackle for the Knights there.
Waltz shooting the gap. And I'll bring up, they'll mark it at the 46, so it'll be second and 11. R.J. Johnson, now over center. Rolling left, under pressure, evades a tackle. Now he's going to be sacked at the 40, maybe the 41-yard line.
So a loss of about five on the play from Prep.
Good pressure there by the Knights defense.
Hey, tell him to let that
in come.
Pull around.
Joshua Heater was in there. Now I'll bring up third down. Third and about 15.
Passing woes definitely continue for Prep.
Johnson throws. He's got a receiver. I think that's King, and he's going to be driven out of bounds, and it'll be a punting situation for Harvest Prep. Good job by the Knights on their defense and containing Harvest Prep and all this speed that they have. So it looks like to be about fourth and 8. Mark the ball at the 49-yard line. And we got Collins and Tobin back in dual safety for the Knights.
Looks like King's back to punt for Prep.
And we got a flag on the play running into the kicker.
Nice
personal foul
there
on the Knights.
Making sure he's okay. Good sportsmanship there by the Knights.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker. And it'll be a first down for Harvest Prep. And the Knights defense, that's a tough punt to try to cover, because he's taking that instead of directly kicking, he's taking that
he's taking a couple steps out. A
couple steps out and just kind of ruins your timing.
Yeah.
But good call. First and 10 for Harvest Prep. Mark the ball at the 40-yard line. Now we got Michael Lang in at quarterback. Johnson split out right in a slot. Lang rolling right. He's going to step up. He's going to run. He's got room. 25 and dropped. First down at the 23, maybe the 22-yard line.
Prep gets loose. They have the speed to keep on going. They found a gap there and did a good job there by Lang.
Now Lang comes off. Johnson looks like will be the quarterback now.
I wish we could get a shot of these fans right here. I don't know what they're dressed up as, but they're showing some school spirit, and I like it.
Lang's still a quarterback. I thought he was coming out. He's kind of shaking his right wrist after that play. Lang steps up, dropped at the 25-yard line. Austin Green on the tackle. Here's Caleb Walls there on the tackle as well. Second and 12. Ball's at the 25. 4 minutes to go here in the first half of play. Single coverage at the top of the screen. Lang hits the receiver.
That was Judah Tutt for prep.
Tutt just a little slant pattern across the middle, caught the ball. Nice gain. It'll be third and 8 with 3:25 to go here in the first half of play. Lang rolling right, throwing into the end zone. It is off of Johnson's hands. Good coverage by the Knights secondary.
Johnson and Johnson!
Grove City leads Lancaster 13-0 with about 6 minutes to go in the second quarter of play.
Got Burn, a Burn down Union. Here for prep.
It's like Burn Union's up 19-7. Fourth and 8. Lang throws left side. He's got a receiver. And he's dropped. A turnover on downs. Good play by the Knights defense here with 2:50 to go in the first half of play. Actually, it's working down to 2:46. So first down for the Knights. Knights up 14-0. Lee over center. Ben Tobin on the carry. Good first down run for Ben. That'll bring up second and 5. Now it'll be third down, and we'll say third and 4. Tobin with 2 back-to-back runs. Oh. Timeout on the field, so we'll take this timeout to let you know that Lancaster Perspective with Mike Miller is on Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. Find perspective on Lancaster business, Lancaster events, Lancaster treasures, and a relaxed, casual conversation with Mike Miller. Lancaster Perspective on LSN Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. And the Road to Recovery with Fairfield County Recovery Center is on LSN TV. Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9, weekly shows about drug addiction recovery hosted by Steve Rao and Trisha Farr. Road to Recovery, Mondays at 11:15 and 4:15, Tuesdays at 12:15 and 9:15, only on Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. We want to thank all of our sponsors for the support of today's game. They're committed to helping Fairfield Media provide community broadcasting for Fairfield County. Appreciate that. they would hear from you that you enjoy our programming and their support. And we thank them for supporting the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. And we got a penalty flag.
Timeout.
No, it's a timeout.
Timeout, nice.
Timeout FCA. So with 2:06 to go in the first half of play, Knights lead by a score of 14-0. So what do you think?
It's a good game so far. Knights definitely putting on the pressure for Prep to perform, and Prep's just struggling offensively, can't get it together, especially the passing game, and they've had that problem seems like all year so far. So
you can't count Harvest Prep out. I mean,
oh, absolutely,
you got a
not.
Hall of Fame coach like Jack Johnson on the field.
Definitely can't count him out.
He is a legend. He really is.
Yep.
And
I'm pretty sure he's the winningest active coach right now in Ohio.
Tell you, it was a coup to get Jack Johnson here.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. He is a legend.
Humble, humble man. All right. Put the ball in play now. Third down, and that's going to back the Knights up. As someone on the left side of the line didn't get the memo of the snap count. So now it'll bring up 3rd and 8. And that was Ben Tobin on the carry.
See if that was good for a first down. No, I'm way off.
All right, so it'll be 4th down, punting situation for the Knights. We'll let you know Hamilton Township leads Bloom Carroll 17-0. And it's 14-0, the Knights over Harvest Prep here late in the first half of play. There you see Ben Tobin on the far right side not being covered. Or is that Austin Beigel? It might be Austin. Tobin. Line drive kick, hits at the 50, takes a night bounce inside the 45. There's Johnson on the return across the 50. And it'll be first down, Harvest Prep. So Harvest Prep's going to try to tack on 7 before they go in for the half. See Brian Miller there and Ben Tobin. Jacob Walker for the Knights on defense. Lang in the shotgun. Rolling left. Looking. Throws. Out of bounds.
Out of bounds for Lang.
That'll bring up 2nd and 10. Bloom Carroll now trails Hamilton Township 24-0. That's late in the second quarter. Of course, Bloom Carroll was a playoff team last year. They hope to get back this year. Lang rolling left, throws. It is incomplete. Now bring up 3rd down. With 1:27 to go. The Warriors don't capitalize here. You might see the Knights try to tack on 7.
Still got time.
Come on, Lang rolling left. He's going to tuck it. He's going to be hit and dropped. Might have gotten back to the original line of scrimmage.
Looks like Tobin can do pretty much everything. Brought down the Warrior right there.
We're at a minute 20 and counting. Punting situation now for Harvest Prep. 4th and 11. Robert King got roughed up last time he punted. He's going to stand at his own 39-yard line. Looks like he's changing a play. And we have, looks like a procedure penalty on Harvest Prep. False start. Back him up 5. See if the Knights try to block the punt or set up a return. They get the ball back to start the second half of play. They may just be content to go in with a 2-touchdown lead. King with a kick. It's inside the, let's see, we got a touchback. That hit at the 20 and just kept rolling, Rawhide. So the Knights will take over 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Got 32 seconds here left in the first half. See what the Knights do here. See if they go for a play.
Of course, the plays the Knights have run tonight that has had the most success have been the running plays. They've had a couple of runs by Jacob Walker for touchdown around the end. Ben Tobin's been up the gut. Caleb Walds has had a couple nice running plays. It's like Lee may just take a knee here, and he does. And as we are at 25 seconds and counting, the Knights will head to the sideline, and I don't think they're going to get another play off. And that'll do it. We got one half in the books here. The Knights lead the Warriors by a score of 14-0. This is the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN.
This year, Operation Christmas Child collected and delivered its 100 millionth shoebox gift since 1993. That's a huge number, especially when the gospel goes alongside each box. Just think of all the lives that have been changed over the years. If that's the power of a simple gift, imagine the amazing power of 100 million simple gifts. Did you know if all the children who have gotten shoebox gifts held hands, they would circle the globe twice? If all 100 million shoeboxes were stacked up, they would be 26,000 times taller than the Empire State Building. 100 million is a big number. Let's put it into perspective. 100 million words? You'd have to read the entire Bible over 120 times to read 100 million words. $100 million? That's more than Michael Jordan made playing pro basketball. 100 million is a big number, but it's not just about that. It's about all the children reached for Christ. There are still billions of children living in need of hope and in need of a Savior. 100 million shoebox gifts is a giant number, but billions of unreached children are waiting. So get involved with Operation Christmas Child.
Hi, I'm Mike Miller, host of Lancaster Perspective. The crew and I would like to extend a formal invitation to you to catch us on Channel 9, Lancaster School Network.
Lancaster Perspective on LSN.
Hey, great party.
Oh, thanks. Here you go. One hamburger, medium well.
This is well done.
No. That's medium well.
What? Are you calling me a liar? This thing is practically burnt.
That's it. You're not going to come to my house and tell me how to cook a hamburger.
You wouldn't do it there.
You gotta be crazy.
So don't do it here. Sportsmanship. It's up to you.
Back here at halftime, Jack Davidson along with Jordan Mills. FCA leads Harvest Prep by a score of 14-0. FCA got on the scoreboard the 7:58 mark of the first quarter of play as Jacob Walker went around left end for a 1-yard touchdown run. And Walker again scored on a 10-yard touchdown run, this time around right end with 7:06 to go in the first half. So it's 14-0, FCA over Harvest Prep. Jordan, what are your impressions of today's game?
Well, FCA definitely came out to play early on. Prep needs to complete some passes. If not, they need to start running the ball a little more. I think if they can break through, they got some speedsters on the team, so they can definitely go through for some touchdowns there.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself? We didn't get a chance to talk about you seeing as we started the game real quick.
Yeah.
You're a graduate of Harvest Prep, right?
Yeah, graduated in 2008 and played
baseball.
You're
an old man then, huh?
I am an old man. That's getting quite depressing. I got some gray hairs now.
You'll have more after the end of this game. Yeah. With me, I'll tell you that right now.
But, yeah, I'm currently going to OU. We touched on that earlier. Majored in broadcasting. And
senior, right?
Yeah, senior.
Very good.
Should be done.
And you
here.
Hope to get into broadcasting then next year then, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. Any door that's open, that'd be great. TV, radio. I'm willing for anything, so here's my application.
This is free here. This is volunteer.
Yeah.
No, you don't get paid here, but JT provides some wonderful Butterfinger candy.
Yeah, he came down and gave me one. I still haven't ate it yet, but I will definitely be eating that.
You just don't do it on air because it does crunch over the microphone.
Yes, I will.
All right, 14-0 here. Halftime scores from around the county. Bloom Carroll trails Hamilton Township. A score of 37-0. Logan Elm is leading Amanda Clear Creek by a score of 21-7. Burn Union and Fisher Catholic tied at 19 at the half.
It's a good game there.
Yeah, that's a surprise. Fisher Catholic came in undefeated in the conference. Union was has played some teams well. They just have not been able to play four quarters consistently.
Yeah, in fact, Harvest Prep is coming off a win against Burn Union last week. I think it was 28-13, so they're definitely hanging strong with Fisher Catholic.
Hamilton Township leads Bloom Carroll by a score of 37-0. So, Harvest Prep will kick the ball off here to start the second half. In the second half, brought to you by, in part, Service Master Clean by Todd George, cleaning services for Fairfield County. They'll help you get clean and stay that way at work and at home. Service Master Clean by Todd George, proud to be a Six Sigma company, demonstrating their commitment to do the job right or do the job over. Service Master Clean by Todd George at 740-687-1077. This Mid-State League Game of the Week airs Sunday at 4 at LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner, Channel 9. Games available on demand at LancasterOhio.tv, powered by YouTube. And you also can go to FairfieldMedia.tv and see games from many seasons back. Robert King will tee the ball up at the 40. Back deep for the Knights will be Junior Collins and Ben Tobin. And here we go to start the third quarter. Collins inside the 10. Goes right side, and he'll be stopped at about the 26, maybe the 27-yard line. First down for the Knights. Jeremiah Lee, the quarterback. Yeah. Game time temperature was 45 degrees. It's gotten colder.
I'd say it's every bit of 30 now.
You think, huh?
If not colder.
Holy smokes. It's 39. You're right. It's, you know, wind chill is probably about 30. Walker has a seam. 30, 35, 40. He may go. No flags. Touchdown, Knights. Okay, you're the senior in college.
Yeah.
How long was that, that run? Started at the 27.
Started at the
27. You can take your socks off, too, and you can use your toes.
That's going to be
73-yard touchdown run.
I was never good in math.
That's why you're in broadcasting. That's why I'm in ministry. 73 yards for Jacob Walker. That's his third touchdown of the night. And the point after is to follow. That comes at the 11:41 mark of the third quarter of play. Ball down. Collins kicks it up, and it is good. Timeout on the field, 11:41 to go. Third quarter of play. On the Mid-State League Game of the Week, FCA leads Harvest Prep by a score of 21-0. Lawn Butler Lawn and Landscape Services, proud to serve Central Ohio communities with full array of services designed to enhance any landscape. The Yard Butler is scheduling fall cleanups and affordable packages at 740-808 or 2580 or online at ohioyardbutler.com. And Fairfield Christian Academy presents the Very Merry Christmas Tour with New Song, Audio Adrenaline, Sidewalk Prophets, Jason Castro, and Love in the Outcome. On Wednesday, December 11th at 7 at Fairfield Christian Church in Lancaster, Ohio. More details at itickets.com. And you can help a child smile this Christmas by packing a shoebox with school or hygiene items and small toys and delivering that pack box to FCA by November 15th. Packing ideas, labels, and more details available at SamaritansPurse.org. Collins will tee it up at the 40. Let's see if he kicks deep. Got Johnson and Woodson Levy back deep. That ball will hit and go out of bounds.
They're sticking with their plan. Just kick it out of bounds. Don't give it to a prep receiver.
And that they have done successfully.
They have, and it's
even
worked
though,
out well.
Yeah, even though they keep getting penalized.
Yeah, it's worth it.
It's
prep has some fast runners there in the back.
So Harvest Prep takes over at their own 35-yard line. R.J. Johnson, now the quarterback. Splitting out to the right is Kirill Wilson. Johnson rolling right. He's going to tuck and get out of bounds. Might have gained a yard on that play. We'll bring up second and long. Good pursuit by the FCA defense. Gain of 2. It'll be 2nd and 8. Nothing. FCA leads Harvest Prep. Next week, FCA takes on Fisher Catholic at Fulton Field. That's a Saturday night game, and we'll have it here on LSN. Johnson rolling left. Stops, throws, long. It is almost intercepted. Austin Green got a hand on that ball. Tendered receiver was Judah Tutt. 3rd and 8. Good crowd here for both schools on a cold, cold night.
They are definitely braving the cold weather. I stepped out for a couple minutes at halftime, stepped right back in the press box.
Smart man. That's why you're a senior.
That's right. I'm thinking.
Johnson throws left side to King, hit in the backfield and dropped. Ling Tolman on the stop. That'll bring up a punting situation for the Knights.
Prep lost a yard on that one as well.
Fourth and nine. This holds true to form. Robert King will go back in punt formation for the Warriors. Looks like he will stand at his 15, maybe his, no, check that, his 21-yard line. Collins and Tobin back deep. There's the punt. High kick. And the Warriors will down it inside the 25-yard line. First and 10 for the Knights.
Pretty solid punt there by King. That was every bit of 50 yards there.
And no wind, too. So, I mean, well, a little bit of wind, but not much. I mean, he got every bit of that.
Certainly did.
First and 10 for the Knights. Second possession of the half. Scored first play of the second half on a 73-yard touchdown run by Jacob Walker. It's been the Walker and Tobin show for the Knights here in the game, and now we got a timeout, FCA. Timeout on the field with 9:59 to go in the third quarter of play. Knights lead by a score 21-0 over Harvest Prep on this Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Central Ohio General Surgeons are physicians with advanced training that allows them to perform invasive procedures for their patients. At Central Ohio General Surgeons, your appointment time includes time for examination and discussion. So you can ask questions at any time. Central Ohio General Surgeons, contacted at 740-654-6213. And we thank them for supporting the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. .9:59 to go, third quarter of play. Knights up by a score of 21-0. If they win out, they will win the Mid-State League Cardinal division in their first year of existence in this league. They stand 12th in the computer rankings, so there's still an outside chance that they get to the playoffs. The top eight make it. Tobin, round left end, cuts up, and he's dropped about the 25-yard line.
R.J. Johnson on the tackle for the Warriors.
Good pursuit by Johnson. We'll bring up second and 10 at the 25. Of course, Harvest Prep has the pink socks on tonight for
just
breast.
Just about to say that. We're thinking alike up here.
Breast cancer awareness. I was at the Browns game a few weeks ago where everyone was wearing pink, even the officials. And when they threw the flags or a towel would drop, you didn't know if it was a penalty or not.
Yeah, I heard they had to do away with that last week. Everyone was getting confused.
I was getting confused, and I wasn't even playing. Lee, quick hitter, Tobin. Across the 40. Fumbled, but I think he was down.
Tayshawn Colvin on the stop for the Warriors.
So Ben Tobin gets another first down for the Knights at their 41. He's got to be close to 100 yards.
Oh, I'd say so, if not already there.
Knights ball. First and 10 at their 41. Tobin the lone setback. Fumble. Lee falls on it. And they'll lose a few on that to the 37. It'll be second and long. I imagine that football is getting a little bit slippery.
Yep.
Lee under center. Tobin. Might have gained a yard on that. Brought down by Hunter Ferris. I'll bring up 3rd and 11. Austin Beigel out wide to the right. Walker, round right end. He's got a seam. He may go. 20, 15, 10. First down, Knights.
R.J. Johnson brought him down from prep.
Jacob Walker running wild. He is over 100 yards tonight.
Between Walker and Tobin, these two guys for the Knights are definite ball players here tonight.
Two seniors carrying the ball for the Knights tonight, Jacob Walker and Ben Tobin. First and goal. Tobin hits the five, still moving to about the three. Brought down by Woodson Levy. Second and goal. We'll mark it at the three. Coming up on 7 minutes to go in the third quarter. Harvest Prep travels to Millersport next week. FCA takes on Fisher Catholic at Fulton Field. He backs up right here. The play's not coming this way. Ben Tobin might have gained a yard on that. And that'll bring up third and goal. Okay, Jordan, you make the call. I would say end around to Jacob Walker. That's worked a couple times tonight for touchdowns.
Yeah.
I wonder if they'll go to the well once too often, but that has worked. And Jacob
keeps working,
has, that's right. Jacob has had some huge gains too. There's Tobin up the gut. He'll be short of the goal line. They'll bring up fourth down.
The Warriors defense is definitely doing a good job there on the goal line.
It's like fourth and goal at the two. Timeout, FCA. Timeout on the field with 5:57 to go here in the third quarter play. Knights lead by a score of 21 to nothing on the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Fairfield Christian Church serves Lancaster for the past 40 years, the corner of Columbus and Whittier Streets near the River Valley Mall. They have Sunday morning services at 9 and 10:30. Trevor Littleton is currently exploring Deep Blue Faith. You visit them online at fairfieldchristian.org. And Redeemer Lutheran Church and yours truly have served the Lancaster area for over 50 years. Located at 1400 Concordia Drive in Lancaster. Sunday services at 10:15. You also listen to Redeemer Reflections on WFCO. That's on at Mondays at 4:35. Lutheran Hour that we sponsor is at 8:30 Sunday evenings. Redeemer Lutheran Church is online at redeemerlancaster.org. And you listen to those radio programs on 90.9 WFCO. Fourth down for the Knights with 5:57 to go.
Be interesting to see if they go for it here. Looks like they are on fourth down. Why not?
And
got it.
Lee on the quarterback keeper, touchdown Knights. Jeremiah Lee, a 2-yard run at the 5:56 mark. Now it's 27-0 Knights with a point after to follow. Walker will hold, and Collins will attempt the point after. Snap, ball down, kick is up, and the kick is good. Timeout on the field with 5:56 to go, third quarter of action. FCA leads Harvest Prep by a score of 28-0 in the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Jacob Walker has had touchdown runs of 1 yard, 10 yards, and 73 yards. And Jeremiah Lee, a touchdown run of 2 yards. That's the scoring for FCA. There you see Mr. Johnson of Harvest Prep. And there's Caleb Walls, my broadcast partner, is on the basketball side. Lancaster is down to Grove City by a score of 19-0 with 8 minutes in the third. Make that Grove City has scored again. It's now 26-0 over the Gales. Here's the kick. This one's a little deeper. Fielded at the 19.
Warriors finally got their hands on it. See what they can do.
Receiver was Terrence Walton. Good return of about 20 yards. It'll be first and 10 for Harvest Prep. So the Warriors will have the ball at their own 38 to start this drive. Got a Warrior down, that's Walton. Looks like he might be cramping. So as they attend to Mr. Walton, allows us to tell you about our sponsors. This week with Sheriff Dave Phelan on LSN TV. Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. Great guests and important information this week with Sheriff Dave Phelan. Mondays at 11 and 4, Tuesdays at noon and 9 on LSN, Lancaster Community TV. Available online at lancasterohio.tv. Lancaster Perspective with Mike Miller's on LSN TV, Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. Find perspective on Lancaster business, Lancaster events, Lancaster treasures, and a relaxed, casual conversation with Mike Miller. Lancaster Perspective on LSN, Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. And The Road to Recovery with Fairfield County Recovery Center is also on LSN TV. Lancaster Time Warner, Channel 9, a weekly show about drug addiction recovery hosted by Steve Rao and Trisha Farr. Road to Recovery, Mondays at 11:15 and 4:15, Tuesdays at 12:15 and 9:15 on LSN. Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. First and 10 now for Harvest Prep. Johnson, a quarterback. Woodson Levy, the deep back. He gets the pitch. Fumbled. Johnson picks it up. Going to try to find somewhere to go.
There he goes.
Bounces out to the left side and runs out of bounds. Close to a first down. Brought out of bounds by Ben Tobin.
Nice to see Johnson make a little play out of nothing there.
And that was nothing.
Yeah.
Tell you, he scooted around that left end. I thought that he had the first down. Stepped out of bounds at the 45-yard line, so it's a good first down play for Harvest Prep. Not the way you diagram it, but it works. Bring up second and short.
I think the Warriors need to work on some more running plays here, see if they can't squeak through that D-line of the Knights.
Johnson. Knocked down.
Looks like he's going to be pretty clear. He did get the first down there.
Introduced to Joshua Coleman on that play. And that'll bring up a first down as they move the chains for the Warriors. First and 10 at their own 49. R.J. Johnson, senior quarterback. Getting his equipment adjusted here by Hunter Ferris. Now he's ready. Two wide receivers to the left, one to the right for Harvest Prep. Johnson rolling left. Heater is applying the heat, and Lane Tolman knocked that ball away. Tended receiver was Carleel Wilson. Good play there by Tolman. Lane's a baseball player. He's a good athlete. He's caught. He's played the infield, pitched. That's one thing the Knights have. They got some good athletes on both sides of the ball, as does Harvest Prep. Second and 10 on the 49. King and Woodson Levy are the backs. Johnson throws left side, incomplete.
Running without the ball.
That was off Judah Tutt's hands. That'll bring up third and 10. Two wide receivers to the top of the screen, one at the bottom. Johnson will tuck it, and he'll get to about the 48 of FCA, and they'll bring up a fourth down.
It looks like he gained a couple yards on the play, but obviously not enough for the Warriors' first down.
Heater was applying the heat. Johnson escaped, and they'll bring up fourth down for Harvest Prep. Punting situation. King will stand at his 40-yard line to punt the ball away. He's gotten some good kicks off here lately. There's a snap. He's going to tuck it and run. Slips a tackle, but he's dropped. Good play by the Knights defense there.
So that was Austin Mosley brought him down.
Austin Mosley and Austin Green snuffed that out, and the Knights get the ball in good field position inside Warrior territory. 4:09 to go in the third quarter. Scoreboard says 4:02. We're going to go with the scoreboard. Mark the ball at the 47, left hash. Beigel out wide to the right. Now Tolman will come set on the left side here. Tolman in motion. This is the first pass by Lee over the middle to Walker. He caught it, and he's in for the touchdown.
R.J. Johnson was on his heels but could not bring the tackle.
That was a 47-yard touchdown pass, Jeremiah Lee to Jacob Walker, and that is Walker's fourth touchdown of the night.
Looks like we've got an injured Warrior on the field there around the 50-yard line. Might just be cramps. Coach Johnson's going out to check everything out.
And Dana Alexander talked about this right at the open. You're going to have to... drink plenty of fluids, even though it's cold. You got to drink plenty of fluids or you're going to cramp up.
Yep. Definitely he made some good points there at the opening of this game.
Dane Alexander on the sideline camera for us tonight. So the Knights take a commanding 34-0 lead over the Warriors with a point after the follow. Walker with four touchdowns tonight. That is in the... We'll put Walker in the conversation for the Male Athlete of the Week for the Eagle Gazette.
Looks like Hopkins is limping off the field, but it looks like he's okay.
So the Knights will attempt the point after here to make it 35-0. So it was 14-0 at half.
Knights came out to play in the second half, that's for sure.
And I don't think they made any adjustments, per se.
No, nothing really too noticeable. Just sticking to what they've been doing the whole game, and it's been working.
Walker to hold. And that is good. Timeout on the field. 3:54 to go in the third quarter. Knights with a commanding 35-0 lead over Harvest Prep in the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Service Master Clean by Todd George. Cleaning services for Fairfield County. I hope you get clean and stay that way at work and at home. Service Master Clean by Todd George. Proud to be a Six Sigma company. Demonstrating their commitment to excellence and their promise to do the job right or do it over. Service Master Clean by Todd George. 740-687-1077. And the Yard Butler and Lawn Landscaping Services. Proud to serve Central Ohio communities with a full array of services designed to enhance any landscape. The Yard Butler is scheduling fall cleanups with affordable packages at 740-808-2580 or online at ohioyardbutler.com.
Little side note here. We were talking about the Jackets earlier, Blue Jackets. They're currently up 2-1 on the Leafs.
All right.
Making a push here.
Let's go Jackets.
That's right.
Fun night in Central Ohio.
Absolutely.
Lots of high school football and the Jackets are playing. Buckeyes play tomorrow night, and I think the Ohio State basketball team has a scrimmage to West Virginia tomorrow. There's the kick that will be falling on at the 20 by King. Could have let that ball go out of bounds,
yeah.
But it'll be first and 10 for Harvest Prep. Yeah, I read the other day that Thad Mata is having the West Virginia basketball team and Bob Huggins up for a scrimmage. I think that's tomorrow. So, basketball season, my land, that's just NBA starts this week.
Yeah.
And college hoops starts about a week or so before Thanksgiving.
Yeah, the Cavaliers were just up here in Columbus. They did a preseason game at the Schottenstein Center.
Did you go to that?
I did not. I'd watched it on Fox Sports.
What were you doing, studying?
Are
Come
you
on,
me?
You're a senior.
I don't study anymore.
There you go. That's the spirit. Where do you go to school again?
Oh,
yeah. Thank you very much. First and 10 for Harvest Prep. I told you we would have fun.
Oh, yeah.
And if you go to fairfieldmedia.tv, you can catch all this later, too. Johnson, a quarterback. King in motion. Johnson rolling left. Throws incomplete. King is the intended receiver. Coverage by Brian Miller.
Offensive struggles continue for the Warriors.
Second and 10.
See if they can't put something together here.
.346 to go, third quarter play. Pitch, Whitson Levy, hit at the 21 and driven back. Heater is there, Ben Tobin is there, and Colin Blackwell was there. I'll bring up third and 9. Johnson, going to escape, 25 up to the 30-yard line, and it'll be short of a first down.
He may.
It depends where they mark it. I think they're going to mark it 29. If you mark it 29,
right.
He's going to be
1 yard short. There.
1 yard short. See, it pays to have binoculars.
Yeah.
Fourth down for Harvest Prep. Fourth and one. They went for it last time. Let's see what they do here. No, nothing to lose. Down 35 to nothing. I'm going to get something going.
Looks like they are going to go for it here.
Let's see what the Knights do on defense. See, they're trying to draw them offside. There's the snap. Johnson will be close.
And
they're going to mark it at the 30. Let's see if it's going to be right at the 30-yard line.
First down, Warriors.
And they move the chains. Now Johnson is down. I think he's cramping as they're trying to stretch him out. And we've got an official's timeout. Allows us to tell you the Fairfield Christian Academy presents the Very Merry Christmas Tour with New Song, Audio Adrenaline, Sidewalk Prophets, Jason Castro, and Loving the Outcome on Wednesday, December 11th at 7 at Fairfield Christian Church in Lancaster, Ohio. More details at itickets.com. You can help a child this Christmas pack a shoebox with school or hygiene items and small toys and deliver that pack box to Fairfield Christian Academy by November 15th. Packing ideas, labels, and more details at SamaritansPurse.org. Started your Christmas shopping yet?
I think I start that December 24th.
Yeah, smart man. Speedway is always open.
Oh, yeah. So
plenty of gift ideas there for you college students. Woodson Levy will be close to a first down.
My dad did that 1 year.
Is that right?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, it was one of the best gifts I ever got. I was a little kid. He bought me a little toy gas station from Speedway.
Is that right?
And my mom got me, you know, hundreds of dollars worth of gifts, and I was just playing with that the whole
time. Well, tell your dad this year, just go to Speedway, get you a gas card. That's all you need is a college
student. Oh, I know, right?
There you go.
Drive to Athens to Columbus every now and again. It definitely sucks up the gas.
First down for the Warriors. Great play there by the Knights. Ben Tobin sacking Michael Lang on the play.
I don't think Lang saw Tobin coming. At least he didn't try to get out of the way.
Tell you, Gentle Ben's got closing speed, but he also has runaway speed, too, as we saw in some of his runs. I mean, he's just a football player.
Oh, absolutely.
Pure and simple.
He's out there to play ball. Offensive, defensively.
Now Johnson is in at quarterback. Low snap. Johnson will step up into the pocket and be sacked. Tobin on the stop.
Again.
Tobin and Caleb Waltz. Minute 18 to go here in the third quarter of play. It'll bring up third and long for Harvest Prep. Johnson rolling right, looking, throwing.
Incomplete.
And that'll bring up fourth down. Austin Beigel on the coverage there. Pass intended for Judah Tutt.
Brings up 4th and 17 for the Warriors.
King will go back to punt. Tobin and Collins will be back in dual safety for the Knights. They'll stand at their own. They're keeping backing up now. The time they stop, it'll be inside their 30. King's gotten off some good punts. There's the snap. There's the kick. High, wobbly kick. That's going to be short. Going to hit at the 42, take a Knights bounce to the 45, 46-yard line, first and 10 for the Knights. Starting at their own 46 with 42.3 seconds to go.
Knights definitely have good field position.
It's been the story of the Knights, the night for the Knights, is that they have had some good field position, and they have controlled the game by running the football.
Yep, they've capitalized every time on that good field position. So,
if I'm not mistaken, I think that last pass by Jeremiah Lee to Walker was the first pass of the night for the Knights.
Yeah, I think you might be right.
Tobin in the backfield. Walker moving to the right. Tobin up the gut. He hits the 46, maybe the 47. It'll be second and long.
It's a good stop there by Hunter Ferris of the Warriors.
Half a minute to go. Clock is moving. We'll see if the Knights get a playoff or not. We got 15 seconds and counting.
Looks like they might just let the clock run out here.
As they head to the sidelines, that'll do it for the third quarter. Timeout on the field. Knights lead by a score of 35-0 on LSN.
MSL on LSN, brought to you in part by
ServiceMaster Clean by Todd George. They are proud to be the only Green Seal certified janitorial service in Central Ohio and promise to do the job right or do it over. 740-687-1077.
Central Ohio General Surgeons are physicians who have advanced training that allows them to perform invasive procedures for their patients. At Central Ohio General Surgeons, your appointment includes time for examination and discussion. Please feel free to ask any questions at any time. 740-654-6213. Thank them for supporting FMP Sports.
This week with Sheriff Dave Phelan on LSN TV. Lancaster Time Warner Cable Channel 9. Great guests and important information on This Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan. Available online at LancasterOhio.tv.
Back here, start of the fourth quarter. Knights lead Harvest Prep by a score of 35-0. Good to have you with us here on LSN. Second and long for the Knights. There's Walker to the 30, to about the 20. Fumble.
Fumble on the play.
Harvest
Looks like the Warriors recover.
Will recover, and they'll be downed at about the 11 or 12-yard line.
I was trying to see who recovered that, but I couldn't pick it up quick enough.
So that turnover gives the ball to the Warriors deep in their own territory. They're down 35-0. It's Jack Davison along with Jordan Mills and the rest of the FCA media team. Glad to have you with us on the FCA on LSN Game of the Week. Come to you next week from Fulton Field. The rivalry game is Fisher Catholic will take on FCA. Johnson rolling right, throwing right side, caught by Judah Tutt. Came back for it. Second down and 5. And now Harvest Prep will be in the hurry up. Johnson looking left, throwing long. He's got Whitson Levy. He may go. 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Harvest Prep. As Jordan has now taken off his socks and shoes to count up the yardage on that.
Yeah, I'm trying to use all my toes here.
1, 2, 3.
I'm going to say that is a 60-yarder. 81 yards.
81 yards.
I didn't have enough toes there.
81-yard pass play from Johnson to Woodson Levy.
Warriors needed that.
Point after to follow. Ball down, kick is up, kick is
no good.
No good.
Shifted to the left a little bit there.
Trenton Dennis was on to kick the extra point. And so the PAT fails. So we head to the early in the fourth quarter here. We got 11:07 to go in the ball game. FCA leads Harvest Prep by a score of 35-6 on the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Central Ohio General Surgeons and their physicians have advanced training, allows them to perform invasive procedures for their patients. At Central Ohio General Surgeons, your appointment includes time for examination and discussion, so feel free to ask questions at any time. Central Ohio General Surgeons, contacted at 740-654-6213. We thank them for supporting Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. And Fairfield Christian Church has served Lancaster for the past 40 years at the corner of Columbus and Whittier Streets near the River Valley Mall. Sunday morning services at 9 and 10:30. Trevor Littleton is exploring deep blue faith. Visit him online at fairfieldchristian.org. So we'll see if Harvest Prep does the onside kick or not here. It's like FCA has the good hands people on. There's a driving kick. Hits at the 10 and goes into the end zone for a touchback. So the Knights will take over at their 20. First and 10 with a little over 11 minutes to go in the ball game. Game time temperature is about 45 degrees. It's down now into the mid-30s.
In fact, it's snowing in the press box.
It is?
Feels like it.
See, as weather like this, it made me want to play basketball. First and 10 for the Knights. Caleb Walls is the lone setback. Tobin gets it off left tackle. He'll gain a few. It'll be second down and long. Got a player down for Harvest Prep.
Looks like 58.
James Johnson.
Cramps has been the problem so far for Prep. Let's see what this might be.
Allows us to tell you that this week with Sheriff Dave Phelan's on Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. Great guests and important information on this week with Sheriff Dave Phelan. Mondays at 11 and 4, Tuesdays at noon and 9 on Lancaster Community TV. Available online at lancasterohio.tv. Lancaster's Perspective with Mike Miller is on Lancaster's Time Warner Channel 9. You can find Perspective on Lancaster business, events, treasures, and a relaxed, casual conversation with Mike Miller, Lancaster Perspective, on the Lancaster Community Network. Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. And The Road to Recovery with the Fairfield County Recovery Center is on Lancaster Time Warner Channel 9. It's a weekly show about drug addiction recovery, hosted by Steve Rao and Tricia Farr. Road to Recovery, Mondays at 11:15 and 4:15, Tuesdays at 12:15 and 9:15, on Lancaster Community TV, available online at lancasterohio.tv. So, James Johnson walks off under his own power, and the Knights huddle up on the far sideline. Second and 6. Ball's at the 24. Caleb Walds is the lone setback. Walker gets the ball around right end, and he's dropped for a loss.
First time all night.
Robert King on the stop. And that'll bring up third down and 8. So mark the ball at the 22. So that play was finally snuffed out by the Warrior defense. We'll see what the Knights come up with now, third and 8. Caleb Walds will be dropped after a 2-yard gain. They'll bring up fourth down. Punting situation for the Knights. Lane Toman will come out to do the honors.
It's the first time the Knights have punted in a while here. Had the turnover the last possession. Scored a couple touchdowns before that, so see their punting unit come out. See what Harvest Prep can do there in the backfield.
Johnson and Curtis Jones back deep. That's Austin Green punting away. Taken by Johnson. Make that Green at the 40. Still moving to the 35. Good punt return.
Curtis Jones on the punt return for the Warriors. He definitely made some things happen there.
So good field position here for the Warriors. First and 10 at the 34-yard line. Still a lot of time in this one.
Yeah, a little over 9 minutes. Warrior fans, we may be down by 35 to 6, but they're still cheering like they were in the first quarter.
Johnson throws left side. He's got King and he slips and falls down. Gain of 2. Second and 8. Johnson now rolling right, flushed out of the pocket. And he runs out of bounds. Caleb Loventhal was chasing him down. And that'll bring up 3rd and 7. Call it a gain of 1. 4 down territory for the Warriors, down 35-6. Johnson evades a tackle, and he's pushed out of bounds. Ryan Miller pushes him out at about the 26. I'll bring up 4th and short.
Warriors have obviously nothing to lose here, so they'll go for it.
Johnson throws, incomplete. And the Warriors have turned the ball over on downs to the Knights with over 8 minutes to go here in the ball game. So the Knights offense comes out, led by Jeremiah Lee. The Knights will try to get a drive here to put this one away. Up 35-6. They've controlled the game for the most part. It was 14-0 at half, and then they just kind of pulled away in the third quarter. Caleb Waltz off left guard. Crossed the 30 to about the 31, maybe the 32. Good gain on first down for Caleb.
James Johnson was on the stop there for the Warriors.
Now he's going to come off. That's good to see, though, because he went down with cramps.
Yeah,
you don't
he
want,
did earlier.
You know, you want to see these kids keep playing. And particularly you know, in any sport, but in football, I mean, you only got 10 games.
Yeah, definitely want to play every one of them.
Second and we'll say 5 for the Knights. Walker in motion. Caleb Waltz off left guard. Across the 35. He'll be close to a first down.
They're going to give it to him. First
and
down.
He'll move the chains. Liberty Union and Circleville tied up at 14 with a little over 7 minutes to go in the ball game there. Good game there. Lions and the Tigers. Lions, Tigers, Bears, oh my.
About to say, where are the Bears at? Another good run.
Walker. See if he gets across the 50. They're going to mark him right at the 50. It's a first down. Good fake there by Lee. As he carried out the fake, he had a lot of the Harvest Prep defense following him, and Walker found a seam down the left side. First and 10 for the Knights. About 7.5 minutes to go here in the ball game. Caleb Walds to about the 44. Good quick hitter. Bring up second and we'll say four. Maybe a long three. Mark the ball outside the 43-yard line. Walds up the guts, got the first down, and dropped at the 38. First down for the Knights. Clock is running. Walker, around the right side, hit and dropped at the 40-yard line.
It's a great stop there by Curtis Jones of the Warriors. He was definitely outsized there, but he brought him down.
Second and long. Knights taking their time here. Walker around left end. 20 out of bounds.
RJ Johnson pushed him out of bounds from the Warriors.
That's at the 15. Jacob Walker is having one fine ball game.
Absolutely. Him and Tobin both definitely combined for a lot of yards tonight.
Coming up on 6 minutes to go in the ball game. This victory will put the Knights firmly in first place with a matchup against the Fighting Irish next week at Fulton Field. That game will be Saturday night at Fulton Field. Caleb Walls spins and gains a few. Second down. Knights went to the playoffs last year. They lost to Newark Catholic up in Newark. They stand in the 12th position now for the computer rankings of Division 7. And I think they may need some help to get in this year. Second and a long six. That play went nowhere. Bobby Leeper was the carry. 5'5 freshman. Had a good game last week against Millersport. Loss on the play will make it 3rd and 10. Knights just taking all the time in the world. Clock's on their side. And we have a timeout, FCA. Timeout on the field with 4:39 to go in the ball game. Knights lead by a score of 35-6 on Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Deemer Lutheran Church and yours truly has served Lancaster for over 50 years. Located at 1400 Concordia Drive in Lancaster. Sunday services at 10:15. You also listen to Redeemer Reflections on WFCO Monday afternoons at 4:35. And the Lutheran Hour on WFCO Sunday evenings at 8:30. Redeemer Lutheran Church is online at redeemerlancaster.org. I want to thank our sponsors for supporting today's game. They're committed to helping Fairfield Media provide community broadcasting for Fairfield County. They appreciate hearing that you enjoy the programming that they support. We thank them for supporting the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. I want to thank you for watching today's game. This sports production is presented by the FCA Media Team. We'll talk more about that in a few minutes as we get ready for this third down play. Third and 10, Knights at the line. And we got a penalty, I believe, on Harvest Prep. As I was saying, the sports production is presented by the high school media students at FCA. Students announcing, students on camera, students on graphics, students producing the game. Fairfield media students are learning teamwork and skills that'll last a lifetime. We thank you for enjoying today's production of the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Third and 5 now. Waltz over left guard. Hit and driven back. He's going to be probably a yard shy of the first down.
It's a nice tackle there by Judah Tutt from the Warriors.
So we'll say 4th and 1 as Lee gets the play from the sidelines. Austin Beigel, wide right. Caleb Walds spins, and I don't know if he got it.
It's going to be close.
See where they mark it.
Yep.
First down. Good second effort by Caleb. So they mark the ball at the inside the 5-yard line. Caleb Wald's the setback. Ben Tobin around left end, and he's dropped. Might have lost a yard there. I think Woodson Levy was on the tackle. Bring up 2nd down for the Knights. 3:20 to go in the ball game. Ball at the 5. 2nd and goal. Tobin. 4-3-2 and driven out of bounds. Good play there by Judah Tutt. Putting the leather to Ben Tobin to drive him out of bounds. 3rd and goal now. As the ball is at the 2. Lee gives to Tobin, and he'll be dropped at the 5.
Nice play there by James Johnson of the Warriors. Brought him down a couple yards back.
Coming up on 120 seconds to go here in the ball game.
Warriors still playing with a little bit of intensity. It's good to see, even though you're down by a couple touchdowns there.
And all Jeremiah Lee, of course, the Knights are trying to score here, but all Jeremiah Lee is doing is looking at the back judge, who will raise his hand with about 5 seconds to go on the play clock. And when he sees that, he'll call for the snap of the ball. There's the raise of the hand. Give to Caleb Wald. Spins, and he's short of the goal line. So turnover on downs. Gives the ball to Harvest Prep. With a minute 24 to go in the ball game. I want to thank the FCA media team tonight. Scott West, Dane Alexander, Caleb Yount, Josiah Lockwood, Connor Doherty, Harrison Poole, Sam Kandra, JT Burcham, of course, Jordan Mills next to me. Have you enjoyed it?
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's good to have you.
Been fun to do this with you guys. Met a couple of your FCA team members earlier. The great bunch of guys.
Besides, up here keeps you out of trouble and from Athens, right?
That's right.
There you go.
Staying away from Halloween
it's
this
our,
weekend.
There's a gain of maybe a foot. Brian Miller came up on the stop. Josh Heater there as well. And we got 65 ticks to go in this one. Second and long. Johnson.
Don't want to get a safety there.
And he is sacked in the end zone for 2 points.
Not what you want to see to end the game.
So that safety by the Knights defense will make it 37-6. And that was just a good intensity by the Knights defense to not give up on that play, and they got pursuit.
It's the way they've been playing the whole game, and it's worked out for them very well.
So this will be in the books for the Knights as a victory. The Knights will go to 6-3 on the season, 4-0 in the Mid-State League Cardinal. Harvest Prep will fall to 3-6 on the season and 2-2 in the Mid-State Cardinal. FCA originally came in, they were tied with Fisher for first place with records of 3-0. Harvest Prep was in third with a record of 2-1. Burn Union at 1-2. And Grove City Christian, Millersport at 0-3. But that'll change tonight. FCA will go to 4-0. If they win next week, they will capture their first Mid-State League Cardinal crown. You can watch that on Fairfieldmedia.tv, Lancaster TV, Channel 9, Saturday night at Fulton Field. The rivalry game, Fisher Catholic and FCA. So King is going to kick the ball off at the 20 rather than punt it. And we have Tobin and Collins back in dual safety at the 30. 41.6 seconds to go in this one. The horse heading into the barn part of the game, huh?
Yeah. Absolutely.
This is hot chocolate time. Of course, Jordan and I are two happy campers because the Blue Jackets won tonight, right?
They did. They won by a final of 5-2.
Send those Canadians home across the border.
Yep, two empty netters to close it out.
That's great.
So,
tell you, the Blue Jackets in the past seasons have been playing like they had an empty net, even though they were playing with a goalie.
Yeah, that is true. We had some problems with Mason, but to have Bobrovsky in net certainly helps us out.
I think that puts the Jackets at 500 on the season.
Yeah, we're 5-5 now.
Collins picks it up. 45, 46-yard line. So the Knights will put the ball in play for the final series here and head home victors over Harvest Prep. If we were to choose a player of the game, probably Jacob Walker would probably get the vote.
I'm going to say Walker or Tobin, hands down.
So now the Knights will be in the victory formation. There's a snap. The kneel. And with 30 seconds to go, this one is over. Knights go home victorious by a score of 37-6. For the FCA media team, Scott West, Dane Alexander, Caleb Yount, Josiah Lockwood, Connor Doherty, Harrison Poole, Sam Kandra on stats, JT Burcham, who runs the show, and Jordan Mills, this is Jack Davidson, thanking you for watching the FCA Game of the Week, the Mid-State League Game of the Week on LSN. Final score, FCA 37. Harvest Prep 6 for this time. Till next time, have a good night, everybody.
Colt International presents the Very Merry Christmas Tour, featuring new song, Audio Adrenaline, Sidewalk Profits, Jason Castro, and special guest, Loving the Outcome. Share the gift of hope with your family and friends this season and enjoy one of Christian music's most beloved Christmas songs. Join New Song for the Very Merry Christmas Tour, featuring New Song, Audio Adrenaline, Sidewalk Profits, Jason Castro, and Loving the Outcome.
Presented by Fairfield Christian Academy at Fairfield Christian Church in Lancaster. December 11th at 7 p.m., doors open at 6. Tickets at itickets.com.